نحمد ونصلي على رسوله الكريم اما بعد فاعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي رب زدني علما. We are doing this Kitabey Tauheed for few minutes, and this is by Shaykh al-Islam Muhammad bin Abdul Wahhab, and it has small chapters. And what is Tauheed? Oneness of Allah. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam spent 13 years in Makkah just on Tauheed, on La ilaha illallah. And there is a 13. And he spent on Tauheed, oneness of Allah, not doing shirk, believing in one Allah, and Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the last prophet. So this has so much importance. And have you noticed Makki surah and Madani surah? And today also I focus on Makki surah, because we are starting this book so that we could understand the difference between. If we understand that, we could understand Quran in a better manner. Because whatever I learn, whether from the Al-Huda or from online university, I want to implement that. So years and years, you know, I spent in grammar and tajweed. I was running after that. Even though I was doing tafsir, but I was always scared about that. I have to do this course, that course. Then in meanwhile, I was thinking we should chase this tawheed also. That is so important. So here, today we're going to see the chapter. Today's chapter is Put Your Trust in Allah. Today's chapter name is Put Your Trust in Allah. Allah the Almighty says, Wa alallahi fatawakkalu in kuntum mu'mineen. Put your trust in Allah if you are believers indeed. This is in Surah number 5, Ayah number 23. He is the most exalted, said. This is in Surah number 8 and Ayah number 2. Innamal mu'minun allazina iza zukirallahu wajilat qulubuhum wa iza tuliyat alayhim ayatuhu zadathum imanu wa ala rabbihim yatawakkaloon. Very beautiful ayah. I love this ayah. How many times I recite this? I love it. This is from Suratul Anfal, Ayah number 2. And if you listen to
that
this
is
ayah,
eight.
Yeah, Surah 8 and Ayah 2. And if you listen this ayah in different voice of Quraysh, you're going to enjoy it. Believe me. It gives you soothing to your ears. The believers are only those, when Allah is mentioned, feel a fear. Fear, awe in the heart. And you know, sometimes when we listen to Quran, we get that goosebumps, yeah. Isn't it? Mm-hmm. And especially, even though, like, you know, I remember long back when I didn't know much about Quran, like, you know, word to word or tafsir, that time also when I heard about Jahannam, I feel that scary. And you know, tajweed teacher, she said, when we say Jahannam, it takes yeah. effort to. Yeah. You remember that day, yeah. how she was explaining? Yeah. So that's how the things are. And in their heart, and when his verses, Quran, are recited to them, they increase their faith. Zadathum imana. And they put their trust in their Lord alone. That is the important thing to note. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the same surah, ayah number 64, Ya ayyuhan nabi, hasbukallahu wa minat taba'aka minal mu'minin. O Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah is sufficient for you and for the believers who follow you. Allah is sufficient for the believers and for you.
Surah was this? Sorry.
This is same surah, surah number 864. Ayah number 64. And another surah, surah number 65 and ayah number 3. وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهُ فَهُوَ حَزْبُهُ. And whoever put his trust in Allah, then he will suffice him. Isn't it? When we are in hardship, we say, Hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakeel, ni'mal mawla, ni'mal naseer. And Allah help us. And you know, we completely pour our heart to the Allah. And it is completely, you know, empty. You know, that word reminds me, afriq alayna. Faragha, you know, you poured out. So we are pouring out towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How beautiful it is. You know, I notice when we call people and we tell here and there, excuse me, and we try to look for a, you know, solution, We don't get it. And when we started praying, especially tahajjud time, you get so much peace and contentment. And you know, like how Surah Sajda mentioned, like when the person, he is sleeping, he feel like, you know, turning and tossing because he want to wake up for the tahajjud. That's what we feel, you know. And that's a good news. Alhamdulillah.
What surah is that?
This one is surah number 65, ayah number 3. وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ الْحَزْبُ. Means Allah is enough for us. And here narrated Ibn Abbas, this is a hadith. Allah alone is sufficient for us. And He is the best disposer of affairs for us. Was said by Ibrahim al-Islam. Then he was thrown into the fire. He said the same thing. You remember when he was thrown in the fire? That's what Ibn Abbas is saying. Hasbunallahu ni'mal wakil. When the hypocrite said, verily the people, pagans, have gathered against you a great army, therefore fear them, but if only increase them in the faith. You know, even though he was in the fire, still iman was increasing. And this is in Sahih al-Bukhari and Nasai. So important issues here in this chapter is to have tawakkal in Allah, complete trust in Allah. And that is our religious duty. And trust upon Allah is tawakkul, is a condition of faith. That's the condition of iman. And explanation of this verse, Al-Anfal. Have a seat. Walaikum salam. I know there's someone I'm expecting, so I thought she's the one. So here there's a explanation of Anfal we have seen. And in Anfal we have seen two ayahs, ayah number 2 and ayah number 64. And we have seen one more, like surah number 65, that is surah At-Talaq, and ayah number 3. And in that also beautifully mentioned, no matter you are going through the separation, but Allah is enough for you. That too it was mentioned, makhraja, how the exit has been taken out. And
makhraja
means kharaja, from exit, taking out. So importance of the words, Allah is sufficient for us and He is the best disposer of all affairs. And you know, Ibrahim al-Islam, always he was hanifan, he was focused. And he was not from the mushrikeen. And Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, at the time of distress, he used to call Allahu Allahu Rabbi la ushriku bihi shayya. You know, all the kalimat which leads to the oneness of Allah. And there is a card which all the duas are mentioned over there. Not only this, and Hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakil, and also La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu minaz zalimin. So there are so many. Yeah. Yes, that also. So we should always praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No matter what calamities we are going through, just praise Allah. You feel that contentment. You feel that peace in your heart. And here, to feel secure against the plan of Allah contradicts Tawheed. You know, sometimes, you know, whatever happens, we should feel content. Don't feel, oh no, you know, we say, what if, that word is low. That word is called low in Arabic. You know, in Urdu we say, kash, if this might happen, this, no, never ever say low kana, you know. So Allah the Most Exalted said in Surah number 7, ayah number 99, أَفَآمِنُوا مَكَرَ اللَّهِ فَلَا يَأْمَنَ مَكَرَ اللَّهِ إِلَّا الْقَوْمِ الْخَاسِرُونَ. Did they then feel secure against the plan of Allah? None feel secure from the plan of Allah except the people who are lost. You know, when Allah plans something, that's it. Don't feel secure. When Allah plans it. That's the end. Allah said in Surah number 15 and Ayah number 56, قَالَ وَمَا يَخْنُتَ مِنْ رَحْمَةِ رَبِّهِ إِلَّا الدَّالُونَ. Who disperse the mercy of the Lord except those who are astray. You know, we shouldn't be despair of the mercy of Allah. Never ever. Sometimes it happens years and years you make dua but you don't get that. But never ever feel despair of that. And this remind me of this, you know, here a word has been mentioned, yaqnut, but in the Surah Maryam, where Zakariya al-Islam keep making dua and he's saying, Rabbi Shaqiya, I am not despair. I still have complete, you know, conviction on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's how we should be. Never ever get despair. You know why despair happens? Shaitan overcomes you. put huzn in your heart, and that time you carried away. Never ever do that. Narrated Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam was asked concerning major sins. Then sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, associating others with Allah means doing shirk, first thing. To lose hope of relief from Allah. The second thing is to lose hope from Allah. Like you know, you are going through distress, but you are losing hope that you are not going to relief from Allah. And this is very important point. You know, worldly things, when we discuss, we say, this is not going to happen. This is never ever say that. That is against the Tawheed. We didn't know that. Like, you know, when I was going through a book, I learned so much. Because first, I am rectifying my mistake. I want to correct myself. I want to correct my aqeedah, my iman. The second thing is to lose hope of relief from Allah. Thinking oneself secure from the plan of Allah. You know, thinking oneself secure from the plan of Allah. We should beg Allah. You know, Allah shouldn't retribute you. If Allah is retributing here in this life, you should rectify your mistakes. You understand what I mean? Like, you know, Allah is catching hold of you in this world. Maybe some worldly thing is lacking. And because of that test, don't lose hope in Allah. Get more attached to Allah. And you think, oh, this is my test and this is because of my sins. Definitely, we are sinful. I tell myself, you know, maybe I did. Definitely, I know I did this. Major sin or minor sin. Allah, me, is between me and Allah. And I beg Allah. Sometimes, literally, we cry in front of Allah. Because we know what we did. Like, you know, we never realize missing salah is a major sin. How many times we delay salah? And in childhood, we thought, like, you know, people sit and do salah. We thought it's okay to do. And one of the elder people said, no, this is the allowance. It's not a luxury. You can't do. Like, we were kids and we thought, okay, you know, everybody is sitting and doing, elder people, why not we do it? So that's how ignorant we were. And many things because of ignorance, we didn't do it. May Allah forgive us. Always ask forgiveness. And it will bring humbleness in your heart. Forgiveness, if you do more and more astaghfar, it brings, you know, more peace to your heart too. And these are the three things we learned. First, associating partner, not to do shirk. Second thing, never lose hope. When Allah will relieve you. Anything, believe me, Allah can relieve you. And the third thing, thinking oneself secure from the plan of Allah. Abdul Razak reported from Ibn Masud radiallahu anhu that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the greatest of major sin is shirk. Shirk is zulmun azim. And for shirk, you know, you have to ask forgiveness. Then only you are forgiven. Unless you ask forgiveness. Major shirk. Major shirk is what? You know, associating partner. You are saying Allah is one, but you are saying, oh, Jesus is son of God. You know, you are believing in something else too. So you can't do that. And associating others with Allah, thinking oneself secure from the plan of Allah to despair of the mercy. All that thing again mentioned here. And important issues of this chapter we discussed was, first of all, in Suratul Araf, ayah number 99. That is, Suratul Araf is surah number 7. And then the explanation of Suratul Hijr, that is surah number 15 and ayah number 56. And the sip.
Yeah, a little bit faster.
Okay, I'll be slow. Yeah. Suratul Araf, and that is surah number 7.
Ayah,
what's that? 99. Yes. And the other explanation we have seen, Suratul Hijr, that is surah number 15 and ayah number 56. Suratul Hijr, surah number is 15, surah number. And its ayah is 56.
Okay.
Yes. And the severity of punishment promised for the who thinks himself safe from the plan of Allah. Don't think you can ever be safe. You know, people think we can hide here and there. You can't hide from Allah and you can't hide from the plan of Allah. Severe punishment promised for the who despairs of the mercy of Allah. Punishment for the people who despair from the you know, mercy of Allah. And here next thing we're going to start our